The support of every my DL Prabhakar and Umesh Bhushi, I created this. It is very difficult to convince everybody in the hierarchy of the bureaucracy. Then one day I able to meet our honorable minister, because we are, when I am studying engineering, he was a student, and we are the same in the existentially front of the college IDSG and IIT. I happened to meet him, our well-wisher, my good friend, my relative, my backbone, Prakash Shetty's residence. Then I told him all these things. Then he told, what is the problem? The next day he called me, how you need your order? That is my responsibility to create one incubation center. That not should be a problem. Like that only I got the order. Then I realized how this city honorable minister, without any hurdles, he sanctioned this one, with the support of our principal secretary Siddhaya. One day I able to travel along with the honorable minister from Mangalore to Bangalore. He was sitting to next to next. Then he started reading the one book that is called Pride India. I don't know how many students you are aware about the Pride India. The Pride India book, around 300 pages, since last 4,000 years, what are the innovations are taken place? What are the research has taken place? He's glancing and he tried to explaining each one by one about the research, how the people are making the this is whatever today you are seeing, this all 4,000 back was existing. He is trying to convincing all these things. Then I realized, oh, this is the background. Otherwise, very difficult to get any permission from the in the political system without anything. He is sanctioned. So I am really grateful to our Sadanand Gowda sir and C.T. Ravi sir about all these things. After these things, now the ball is our university, the responsibility our vice chancellor. Because whatever I taken the research center, this is with the support of VTU. Because I don't want to create this is for only for the Sahyadri. This is my dream. I want to create not only the student, any common man is coming with ideas. Any ideas that should become in the reality, that should be, this is the center. So I am requesting our Vice Chancellor, sir, you want to take lot of initiative in this and you want to support us. The Center of Excellency and Research Center both will be biggest milestone in the history. When near about our six people of IIIT people, once they completed their higher studies, the same type of the labs are set up in this institution. I can very confidently I can say that in front of our Honorable Minister and Vice Chancellor, within 5 years, this institution will produce minimum 10 to 15 PhDs in the quality of the IIIT. If you set up the lab, why I am telling, sir, we can set up the lab, that will be constrained only for our college. That much of the usage will not take place if you have only one college. My interest along around 20 to 25 colleges in and around the district, each student should get the benefit. So I am requesting the Vice Chancellor, sir, kindly set up mechanical lab and civil lab, and also we need a status of our placement and training for the university level. You should take as a, this is a placement and training center where our student in and out get the training, and we can invite the companies for here, sir. So once again I am making requesting in with you, sir. Dear friends, sir, we are going another one milestone with the university. Today, lot of specialization MBA, what industry need, what student want, this is our idea. So I requested all cargo people, this is the logistic will take the major role in the future. So I requested all cargo chairman to take as a specialization subject in MBA. Already he's deputed his CEO, Mr. Nishant. We have a discussion with the Vice Chancellor. In the span of another 6 months, there's another one specialization course in the MBA that the logistic will start. That will be the great boom for this area students who want to take up this matter. Sir, when we started the institution, we are facing very biggest problem, toughest the problem is the faculty. But today I want to tell in front of the Minister and Vice Chancellor, sir, we took the different initiate in this to develop our own faculty strength. Whoever interested to come as a faculty, and we ready to sponsor that students, either in the bachelor degree, either in the master degrees, either in their postdoctorate. Our idea, the students should get the good experience from the day one about the teaching. That he should return back, not for our trust. We have started a one Sahyadri Corpus Fund. The Corpus Fund main intention, whatever the money they are giving back us, that is for investing for the research and development activities. Sir, very happy to inform you that already our Corpus Fund is developed up to 1 crore. When I generated the 50 lakhs money, then Alcargo Chairman Mr. Shashi Kiran Shetty is assured me another 50 lakhs for this Corpus Fund to promote the education and research. Sir, we taken lot of initiative in the last 5 years. Our sports students created the history. In the last 15 years, the sports meet continuously. The last 3 years, the hat trick, our students are champions. Out of 200 colleges, out of 200 engineering colleges, nearly 2,000 students are participating. The college from Sahyadri, they came up with a colorful. Earlier, this always prize was mentioned only for the city, only for the few colleges. In the last 3 years, we are created the history. So I am not taking the much time. And another one thing I want to tell you, in the last 3 years, sir, we had more than 300 industry interactions. Today, any guy, you ask any company, that company, industry people are came, they interacted with the students. Our motto, our students should have the good exposure to the industries. Today I want to thank so many people who are given the support. Finally, I want to thank Mr. Amar Kumar Pandey. Even though he's a police officer, he's very much concerned about the computer knowledge and you know how to give his knowledge to the students from all over the field. My classmate today is owning his own IT company from Chennai, Mr. Subramani. He is also came. Lot of people today coming for the, I have the collaboration with us. Within another 5 years, I will tell this will be the one finest engineering college. Finally, I want to tell the minister, sir, Vice Chancellor, sir, this is not, I want to keep the college myself only. This is open. If the university want to take any initiates, I am ready to give that my college to the university. If you want, the government want to take over, absolutely no problem. I have created, I am the happiest person because only my dream, this institution should be developed and identified as one of the best institution in the country. When Tripathi sir was came to us, in the 3 years back I offered, sir, if you are ready to take this institution to run, I am the happiest person to hand over to you. Come and take and run the institution because our dream and our imagination to create the good people, good citizen to this country. Thank you very much. Whoever else supported for me, all my faculties, all my students, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. A man of excellence with a proven track record in the area of research is Dr. Shankar Prasad. He is the founder, director and chairman of the Sampurna Swaraj Foundation. Dr. Shankar Prasad was instrumental in introducing the e-governance in local governments like panchayats. It's worth mentioning that Dr. Shankar Prasad worked with Steve Jobs, the CEO of Apple.
Honorable former Chief Minister Sadanand Gowda, Education Minister Mr. Ravi, Mr. Katil, Mr. Palemar, Dr. M.D. Tiwari, Professor Mahesh Appa, Mr. Siddhay is not here, and other dignitaries on the stage, and my dear friends. In our Vedic scriptures, one of the most important scripture is Yoga Vasishtha. Many of us probably would not have heard of it. In Yoga Vasishtha, there is a small story, and that is called the Kakataliya Nyaya. This is, there is a tree with a fruit, and a person is sitting under the tree. A crow flies onto the tree, sits on the tree, the fruit falls, and the man eats and he is happy. Now the question is, was the fruit ready to fall, or did it fall because the crow sat on it? And if the fruit did not fall, was the man going to be hungry? Now this is what we call coincidence. And Mr. Bhandari is the creator of coincidences. I did not know Mr. Bhandari a few months ago. Honestly, I did not know what he was doing. But this divine coincidence of meeting a dreamer, a visionary, was actually a luck for me to be associated, to be with such a person. So this kind of coincidences, for example, when he met Professor M.D. Tiwari, he met him in Delhi by chance, and he took that coincidence and created something very unique, which is a cooperation between IIITB and Sahyadri. When Manjunath talked about starting this research center, it was one of the dreams and visions that I had of setting up a center where science, engineering, technology is used for social transformation. So I suggested to him that we should set up a center which integrates multiple fields of science, engineering, technology, and not just that, make sure that it is actually valuable to the society. That means we have to understand different concepts of social science, political science, public policy, and so on. Today, it's a pleasure to be here, to be part of this new Integral Research Center, which is going to be called the Integral Center for Science, Engineering, Society, and Spirituality. The interesting concept is, a lot of you would probably think, why the word spirituality for a center which talks about science, technology, and society? Spirituality is not religiousness. Spirituality is something that one experiences as an individual that brings joy that is beyond materialistic wealth or materialistic joy. When we listen to Lata Mangeshkar, or when we listen to Darbari Kannada by Jasraj, there is a spiritual experience of joy. As young boys, if you get a chance to dance with Katrina Kaif, that's a spiritual experience. Because, and as a girl, if you get a chance to dance with Shah Rukh Khan, wow, that's a spiritual experience. When Mother Teresa treats a leper, it's a spiritual experience. When Einstein wrote E equals MC square, it's a spiritual experience. So spiritual experience comes in different forms of compassion, love, forgiveness, and most importantly today, creativity. Creativity brings a joy that only individuals who have done it know what that joy is. So we are hoping that in this new center, we will merge science, engineering, technology, which is useful to society, because as we know, the public servants like Sadananda Gowda, Mr. Ravi or Palemar, public service gives a high that normal people would never know. The joy of Janaseve is a fantastic joy that normal people would not know. And it is an opportunity for normal scientists, engineers to serve the people and feel the joy of Janaseve. Janaseve, as you know, is Janardana Seve. Now the question is, how do we do this? We have to bring a new paradigm of doing research and development in this center. It is not the usual R&D centers that we have seen in India today. So here is an opportunity for us to look at research from a multidisciplinary approach. This is not research that will develop technologies to improve the economic health of a citizen. It is not just to improve the what we call the HDI, the Human Development Index. It is technology and science used to improve the happiness index of man. And that is the way we have to look at with this R&D center that Manjunath Bhandari has visualized. Now, in order to actually operate such an R&D center, we need what we call higher complexity of thinking. Higher complexity of thinking automatically means that you must have a versatility of different fields of science, engineering, social science, and so on. And that is the way we are going to operate this, where different kinds of people from NGOs, different institutions, students, faculty, government, and even businesses, whether it's IBM or All Cargo Logistics, will bring different kinds of people to work on a specific problem in an integrated way. There are 7 steps that we intend to follow in this, and this is what I call the Saptapadi. Researching the need of the society, understanding the need of the society, assessing the need of that particular situation, anticipating the implementation and its challenges and outcomes, developing solutions, outreaching to the actual beneficiaries, and finally monitoring the technology as after it is implemented. And here is an opportunity for us to actually change the paradigm where the beneficiaries of the science and technology research will be part and parcel of the research from the beginning. And this is the uniqueness that we want to bring to this R&D center. Without taking much time, I just want to tell a small story before I leave and ask other people to talk. We all know a caterpillar. A caterpillar, before it becomes a butterfly, it oozes a lot of gooey stuff, forms a cocoon. When it oozes a lot of gooey stuff, automatically there are special cells that are latent in the caterpillar that are called imaginal cells. That means you do not know, you have to imagine what those cells will become. And those imaginal cells fight back, but when they fight back, they actually create more imaginal cells. And as more imaginal cells are created, some imaginal cells become the wing, some become the color, some become the antenna, and the caterpillar becomes a butterfly.